New configuration table. ZW3D 2018 adds a new unified part and assembly configuration table. Firstly, part configuration can manage more parameters, such as part attributes, expression, feature, and dimension. Take the screw as an example. Open config table. Based on the current part model, all configurable items are listed on the left side of the dialog. Pick the needed variables to define one configuration. And add one copy feature into the table. This is the default part configuration. Next, create a new one and name it M2-L3. The same parameters will be automatically inherited. Checking this box means that this feature is suppressed. Then create another new configuration and name it M2.5-L3. 2.5 represents the diameter of the screw. Reset these parameters to get the right model. Click Apply to save these configurations. Also, we can export this data to an Excel file. Then quickly set the parameters. In Excel file for feature, 0 means the feature is unsuppressed, and 1 means the feature is suppressed. More configurations can be defined. Then, save the Excel file. Next, data can be imported from the Excel file. Before activating the configuration parameters can be verified to discover the mistake early. Close the config table. All defined configurations are listed in the History Manager. Double-click to activate one and view the result. This is another case, nut. Open the config table and check the predefined part configuration. Secondly, let's take a look at assembly configuration. Assembly configuration supports part configuration, component color, position, constraint, and value. Let's create a new file. Firstly, insert the screw. Select one part config and anchor it. Then insert the nut. Pick the cylinder surface to add the concentric constraint. Next, pick two planes to define the coincident constraint and set the off value as 1 mm. After that, open config table to define assembly configuration. Add part config, color, and constraint value into the table. Select the default part config to define the default assembly config. Next, create a new one. Select the matching part config and set different color. The constraint offset value can be reset. All defined assembly configurations are listed in the manager. Double-click to activate. In an assembly, it's easy to manage different assembly status with config table. At last, create a new file to verify these assembly configurations. Firstly, insert the default one. Then, this assembly status can be changed easily by changing the configuration.